that there are some things that just can't be learnt. We'll put your revision notes to one side for the first ever episode of Shed Science. Biologists who study animal behaviour have traditionally thought that all behaviours fall into one of two categories. Number one, the behaviours that can be performed from birth without any experience, or the learned behaviours. Or number two, the behaviours that require experience and learning, or the learned behaviours. Innate behaviours were seen as simple and genetically programmed to allow the animal to survive just after it's been born without any experience. Learned behaviours are generally seen as more complex and result from the animal's interaction in its environment. One example is habituation. You hear your alarm clock going off in the morning and the loud noise makes you think something dangerous is happening and you wake up, but nothing happens. This false alarm is repeated so much that your body thinks, hang on, this noise isn't dangerous at all. Then you don't wake up for your lectures on time, you have to get changed and have breakfast and brush your teeth and go to labs in 5 minutes and it all goes horribly wrong. But life is not black and white, and anyone can see that there will be both a genetic and environmental basis to behaviour. The relative importance of each one is what has spurred the massive nature versus nurture debate. And how do we solve debates in science? With an experiment. In this case, isolation experiments are really enlightening. As the name suggests, an isolation experiment involves looking after an animal from birth in captivity and keeping it away from all other living things. This means that we can effectively ignore all environmental effects, and anything that we do see must therefore be genetic. This is a chaffinch, and this is chaffinch song. It always has a regular structure, lots of repeated notes that get faster, and then a terminal flourish at the end. Biologists wanted to know whether chaffinches knew how to sing from birth, i.e. innate behaviour, or whether they had to listen to other chaffinches to learn how to sing. So after rearing some chicks in a soundproof chamber, they found that their song was like this. The repeated notes sound recognisably chaffinchy, but it lacked the terminal flourish at the end. This quite strongly suggests that the behaviour is partly innate and partly learned. But here's where it gets really interesting. They tried teaching chaffinch chicks the songs of other birds, but they just couldn't do it. Although the chaffinches had to learn the chaffinch song, they just didn't seem to have the brain power to be able to learn the songs of other birds. Biologists were still puzzled, so they decided to look into it even more by investigating baby chimpanzees. Baby chimps aren't afraid of snakes or flowers at first because they learn what to be afraid of from watching their parents. And so the researchers showed the baby chimps a video of their mother being either scared or not scared of a snake or scared or not scared of a flower, and then tested the reactions of the baby chimps again. If they saw their mother was afraid of snakes, then the baby chimps were much more afraid of snakes than the chimps that had seen their mother not afraid of snakes. But big deal, you might say, it's what we'd expect. But then with flowers, it made barely any difference whether the mother was scared or not. Either way, they showed no fear. So it seems that the ability to learn is genetic, and that not everything can be learned. Evolutionarily speaking, this makes perfect sense, because it means the animals can learn survival skills really quickly, for example, being scared of dangerous snakes. But it does allow a degree of flexibility. So if there aren't any dangerous snakes in the area, they don't have to spend time being scared of them. I would tell you more about that, but I don't think you're genetically programmed to learn it, so I won't bother. If you'd like to learn more about learning, then I've put some references in the description bar below, or you can ask me a question either in the comments or on Twitter at Sally LePage. If you'd like to be updated on when I post new videos, then please click subscribe. Thanks for watching and keep smiling.